Good day or good morning, depending on where you are in the world. Today we are going to go through the 5-paragraph essay. As I have been grading some things and working on some of the submissions that you guys have given, I've noticed that quite a few of you are having trouble with the fundamentals of the 5-paragraph essay. So we're going to go through that today. So when dealing with the 5-paragraph essay, we have 5 parts. You have your introduction. You typically have 3 body paragraphs, and then you also have that conclusion. All right, so what's the purpose of the 5-paragraph essay format? And that is essentially just to help you better organize your thoughts. Otherwise, if you don't use that 5-paragraph format, you might just ramble on or just have an informational text where you have just added all the information that you know about a particular topic. So using that format, that 5-paragraph format, that helps you to eliminate the rambling and just adding information. And so as you grow in your writing, as you get older, this format is going to grow with you, so that as your writing style changes, this will just be the foundation of how you write, using that format to organize and keep your thoughts from rambling. All right, so what are the parts of the introduction? The first thing that you need to do is hook your reader. The hook is just like what you would think about if you're fishing. It's something that will grab their attention. Sometimes people use a statistic, they might use a question. There are different ways to do that, and I'll make some videos about that later on. So then you also have your topic sentence that tells the reader what you're going to talk about or what that topic is, introduce them to it. Then you provide your supporting details, and then that very last sentence in your introduction is your thesis statement. That's where you guide the reader. You're essentially telling them what your essay is going to be about. All right, for your first body paragraph, the first thing that you're going to do is refer back to your thesis statement. Typically in a thesis, you might list 3 things that you're going to discuss. The first body paragraph, you're going to look back at that thesis statement, and your topic sentence is going to cover one of those points in your thesis statement. Once you've decided which point it will be, try to keep it in the same order. So if you have them listed as apples, bananas, and cherries, then your first topic sentence will cover apples. Then you want to talk about the supporting details or give those supporting details and your concluding sentence. You're going to do that for each of your body paragraphs. Again, the topic sentence refers back to that thesis statement, but in body paragraph 2, you're going to get whatever that second point was. Then you're going to give your supporting details and then your concluding sentence. Your third body paragraph, you're looking back at that thesis statement in that introduction. Again, getting that last point, adding those supporting details, and then concluding your sentence there. And then finally, you've made it down to that conclusion paragraph where you're going to restate your thesis. So I keep mentioning the thesis because that is the most important part of your essay. That is the foundation of your essay. So when you get to that conclusion, you're going to restate the thesis, add those supporting details, which will be a summary, those things that you have discussed in those body paragraphs, and then your concluding sentence or your clincher, some people call it. Sometimes it's looked at as an opinion or your feeling, the writer's feeling toward the subject that he or she is writing about. All right, so let's look at a sample paragraph that shows this process in hand. All right, so introduction, start off with your hook. Statistics have shown that more Americans are overweight now than at any other time in our history. That's our hook. That's to pull you in, to get you to want to read what I've discussed. And then your supporting details. It's important for everyone to get some form of exercise every day. Exercise helps you control your weight. It can also help you stay mentally alert. In addition, it keeps you fit. Those are your supporting details. All right, these are just a few reasons why daily exercise is important to everyone. And that thesis statement is referring to those 3 supporting details, those 3 items that you've listed prior. So pay attention as we go into the body paragraphs, looking for those topic sentences that relate to your thesis statement. All right. Topic sentence. Exercise helps you control your weight. Thinking back, you know that that comes from that thesis statement from your introduction. All right. It burns up calories that are being stored as fat. It helps you eliminate excess calories before they can be stored as fat. Additionally, because exercise helps suppress your appetite, it helps you control the amount of food you eat. These are a few ways that exercise helps you control your weight. So topic sentence, supporting details, and then your clincher or your concluding sentence there. Body paragraph two, again, that topic sentence is a part of your thesis, referring back to it. Exercise keeps you mentally alert. When you exercise, you breathe more. With each breath you take, you are taking in more oxygen. Oxygen is necessary for our brains to function and for us to feel awake. All of these enhance mental alertness. All right, again, referring back to that thesis statement. Body paragraph three, exercise keeps you fit. Part of that thesis statement, again, those are the 3 points that you discussed in your introduction, saying that that's what your body paragraphs or what your essay would be about. All right, aerobic exercise works your heart and keeps it working efficiently. Strength training keeps your muscles in shape and your bones strong. Activities like yoga keep you limber. Combining different types of exercise can help keep you fit. Again, topic sentence, supporting details, and then your conclusion statement. All right, finally down to the conclusion, which is your paragraph number five. In conclusion, I've started also using a transition word here. It's important to get some form of exercise every day. The first sentence in your conclusion is a restatement of your thesis because you want to remind your reader what your essay was about, and then you're going to summarize the things, pick out those most important things that you discussed. All right, exercise helps control your weight. Exercise can also keep you mentally alert. Finally, it helps you stay fit. In order to fight the rising trend of obesity, it's vital that every American get some form of exercise every day. So, covered your conclusion with that restatement of the thesis statement, a summary of the things that you've talked about, and then the clincher, which is basically your opinion or your feeling about the topic. And looking at this clincher, we can see that the writer has some strong feelings about what you need to do in order to ensure that you are not overweight. All right, so I have covered the 5-paragraph essay. I'll be sending these out from time to time to kind of give some pointers to you guys. If it's something that you are struggling with that you need some assistance with, please let me know. I'll be glad to create a video for you. If you have any questions, you can let me know. I hope that you guys have a great day.